A very good evening, my dear children. This is Dr. Wan.
A very good evening, my dear children. This is Dr. Wan. A very good evening, my dear children. This is Dr. Wan.
And I hope you're all able to hear me and see me. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. How are you doing? Happy, excited? How was the day? Did you see the morning three lectures? Were you there for the super amazing lecture in the morning on probability? After that, an even better lecture which we did on national parks, and then we did a lecture on cell. And now here we are with another lecture on the general characteristics of the plant kingdom and algae specifically. Very important lecture. Yes, should we start today's amazing lecture? Good evening. So happy to have you all. So happy to see your stars there, to see your hearts. Good. Yes, chale. Shuru karte aaj ki class, specially my dear 2022 batch. 2020 aapka bahut achha revision ho raha hai. 2021 aapko is revision ki bahut zarurat hai. And 2022, my dear Chunu Munnu batch, my cute little batch, this is for you because you are developing your basics. So in all my lectures, we have never missed a single point. We've gone step by step. We're trying to build really strong and solid basics on the basis of which we will make a big mansion for NEET 2022. So let's move ahead with today's class. My dear 2021 Reproduction Organisms, NCERT exemplars, the class which we could not take yesterday. Right, we are going to be taking that today at 9 o'clock. You all need to become a part of our Telegram group. It's one of the most amazing Telegram groups because there's a lot of motivation, there's a lot of positivity, there's a lot of hand holding, telling you discussions, questions, all of this and much more. And we have a simple ID, just say our Telegram group join us at Vedantu_biotonic. Vedantu Biotonic. Right, it's your one-stop destination, this is what I say, for all things biology, for getting a rank in KVPBI, to getting a rank in NEET, to like whatever in bio can you dream of. This is your one-stop destination. Yes, all last year's students have cleared KVPBI exam, and this year, so my God, we're going to rock NEET 2020, which is going to be there on 26th July. If you want to see a part, see my webinars, you want to become a part of my regular classes, all of this and much more awaits you on the Vedantu app. So app ko download zarur kijiyega and make sure you like, you share and you subscribe to our channel. Are you doing that, guys? Everybody? Thank you, Tanveer. Are you all making sure that you're liking, sharing, subscribing to our channel? Yes, your support is equally important to us as our support is for you. It's a symbiotic relationship. Yes, so make sure that you like, share and subscribe to our channel. Ek choti si announcement, vdnt.in/ytlife pe hamara sara, you know, the entire platform of Vedantu is the most beautiful platform ever. The platform with which I've been associated for the past 10 years. I have never in my life changed my job, you know. That's the kind of job satisfaction one derives at Vedantu. I have been a part of Vedantu from the beginning. Yes, the oldest bio teacher of Vedantu, one of the oldest teachers of Vedantu. So make sure, vdnt.in/ytlife, which is our sara platform humne aapke liye free kar diya hai, you do come in and you do join our platform. Yes, mujhe kabhi zarurat hi nahi lagi ki main ek jagah se dusri jagah jaun. Whatever I wanted to do, whatever I wanted to achieve, and with folded hands, I've got all of that and much more at Vedantu. Yes, so a little heart for Vedantu, a little heart for me. And chaliye, aage badhte class shuru karte. Aaj ki class bahut bahut amazing hone wali hai. Open your copies, papers, pens, open your NCERTs, everybody, and let's get going with a really nice class. Done? Start kare? Yes, and no missing. Menti hoga class ke baad. To ek baar hum class le lete and then we will move to menti and let's see what we'll do in the menti. Acha, aaj ke menti ke winner ke liye there's a special prize. Done. Small cute gift from my side for today's mentee winner. So let's see who listens to the entire class and who wins the mentee in today's class. Done. Happy? Okay, a chota sa gift from Mani ma'am's side to somebody who wins the mentee in today's class. Okay, let's come to the characteristics of plant kingdom. Plants are autotrophic. They make their own food. They don't move. I wish ye move karte to bechare they would have not got, you know, deforestation itna zyada nahi hota, but they do not move. These are conifer trees. Everything is a plant, from gymnosperms to conifers to algae to bryophytes, ferns. All of this comes under plant kingdom. We start from algae in today's class. Beautiful diagrams of algae, and then we move ahead and do the entire plant kingdom. So plants, can you see the slides properly? Is it clear? One like if you're all able to hear me, see me and see the slides clearly and properly. Done? Perfect? Chalo. Okay. So they are multicellular. They have a lot of cell. They have a nucleus, eukaryotes. All these words should, like, you should be able to easily understand all these words now because we've already done all these words, right? One second. I think it's much better now. Indeed it is. Indeed it is much better. See, when you single-handedly maintain the entire studio, sometimes it becomes problematic and you're not really able to manage, you know, the bug, the little side thing or a little glitch here and there, but I think you will all be able to understand it. Hai na? Chaliye. So it's much better now. So plants aapke multicellular hote hain, eukaryotes hote hain, I hope you will understand. And they have a central large vacuole. So the cells look like this, vacuole hota hai, and the nucleus is pushed to the periphery. Write this point down, very important. Inke paas photosynthetic pigments hote hai, chlorophyll A, B, C, D, E, we will talk about it in detail. They have different organelles, NCRT ke charts aaj discuss kiye jayenge aapke saath. They have different organelles for anchorage, right? So they might have root-like structure, right? Anchorage ke liye, reproduction ke liye, support. Photosynthesis support ke liye, they will have stem, tendrils. They usually reproduce sexually. Right? These are general features of plant kingdom. Please underline all the points that I told you. The ones which come in MCQs, autotrophic, multicellular, they have a nucleus, large vacuoles, photosynthetic pigments, right? And they reproduce sexually. Important from MCQ point of view. Moving ahead to the next slide now, my dear children. What are the systems of biological classification that we see in plants? Let me just go back, whether we've not missed any slide, should not miss. Yes, very good. What are the systems of biological classification of plants? What I want you to do is, thank you, Nitisha. Thank you, Afsar, Vanshita, Niranjana. Pay attention. So what are the systems? Click the snapshot. Sabse pehla system is the artificial system, which was the first ever system to classify plants, which was given by the scientist called Carolus Linnaeus. Artificial system, it is a MCQ. It was based on vegetative, which means asexual characters like stem, root, which we can very clearly see. Underline, write it down please. Or superficial morphology is the one that we can see. Habit, kaisa hai plant, habitat kaun se pe reh raha hai, kaise leaves hai, kaisa color hai, number and shape of leaves, all of this is artificial system. Then we move to a little more system which was given by Bentham and Hooker. Very important from MCQ point of view. Bentham and Hooker ne ek system diya tha. This was artificial. This is natural system. In nature, how do the plants stay with each other? Very, very important. Nature mein plants ek dusre ke saath kaise rehte hain? Are you making notes in the class? Are you making notes in the class? First tell me. Yes. Very, very important classes going on. Systems of biological classification in plants are very important. Let me tell you, the most amazing, easy slides, you will not have to refer any other book. Natural affinities pe kisne diya? MCQ, Bentham and Hooker. Includes the external features and internal features also. This was only based on superficial characters. Here, you started to include the internal features. That is why it becomes very important. How does the root look from inside? How does the plant look from inside? How does the embryo look? So, classification for flowering plants only was given by Bentham and Hooker. From inside, what is the stem looking like? What is the leaf looking like? What are the roots looking like? Right? So the first system, again, in every slide, I'm trying to summarize everything. Artificial system only on superficial external characteristics given by Linnaeus. Natural system given by Bentham and Hooker on both internal and external, you know, variations or similarities. Phylogenetic. This word has come in exams at least 10 times. Phylogenetic is based on evolutionary relationship. When the plant undergoes evolution, how does it look? What came first? Algae, then who came? Oh, bryophytes, then who started to come? Oh, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and then angiosperms. How are they evolving? What are the internal changes which are taking place? Assumes that organisms in the same taxa have a common ancestor. So if they belong to the same taxa, these are evolutionary relationships. So these are the three types of systems of classification: artificial system, natural system, and phylogenetic system. Very, very important. Very important. Right? Evolutionaries pe har saal every year questions will come. So what have we done till now? We have done the general properties of the plants. I told you that they are eukaryotic. They will have pigments. They will have a central vacuole. I told you three systems. One given by Linnaeus. One given by Bentham and Hooker. And the third called the phylogenetic system. Moving ahead. Now also, you can generally classify plants on the basis of whether they make seeds or they don't make seeds. These do not make seeds. That means the first one, jo hum aaj padhne wale, algae, usme seed nahi hote. There are no flowers, there are no fruits, and yes, there are no seeds. Has no. And guys, don't forget today's mentee. The winner of today's mentee will get a special prize from me. Is that clear? Thank you, Anuj. Pay attention in the class, please, everyone. Koi root nahi, koi stem nahi, koi leaf nahi. It's basically referred to as thallophyta. There is no differentiation, no root, no stem, no leaves. It's a very interesting class, pay attention. Right? Has no roots, stems, leaves, structure, algae. Moss, some roots, stem or leaves, some. Little, just about to develop. Moss has root, stem and leaf. First one, ferns. So algae, bryophyta, very less root, stem, leaf. Develops root, stem, leaves for the first time properly, ferns. Then the ones which make seeds, gymnosperms have no flowers and no seeds. That's why it is also referred to as the naked seeds. Please write this down. These are the ones which have cones, called the gymnosperms. I'm sure I've got a specimen for you. I'll get you a lot of specimens as and when we study plant. So you must have seen cones like these. Have you? So these cones are nothing but conifers, gymnosperms. Here these leaves are called sporophylls. You have seeds on the leaves. They do not have any fruits. No flowers, no fruits, naked seeds. And you look at this Helianthocoenus sunflower. It will have flowers, fruits and seeds. So it's a very general, simple classification. Right, everybody? Ma'am, need 2020-2021 wale, hum 2022 walon ko first nahi aane dete, aisa nahi hai. Aap to fresh padh rahe ho, aapko bhi yaad rahega. Right? To ek bachcha teeno batches se liya jayega. Ek bachcha 2022 se, 2021 se aur 2020 se. Kisi ke saath partiality nahi ki jayegi. Done? Theek hai? Leaderboard mein teeno batches ek ek bachche ko choose kiya jayega. Happy? Chaliye, muskuraiye, aap Vedanta Biotonic mein hai. Yes, aaiye. Chale? प्लांट किंगडम में शुरू करते हैं. आज की क्लास में हम शुरू करने वाले एल्गी से. चले स्टार्ट करें. यस नो शिखा. ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद प्लांट किंगडम एल्गी. वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. एवरी ईयर वन क्वेश्चन फॉर योर नीट एग्जामिनेशन विल कम एंड वन क्वेश्चन योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स विल ऑल्सो कम. और थैंक यू सो मच प्रतिभा. दैट्स सो स्वीट ऑफ यू प्रतिभा माई डियर. चलिए आइए. So characteristics of algae family. ये सारी algae हैं. ये red algae, ये green algae, right? All of these are algae. थोड़े दिन पहले मैंने एक red algae की थोड़ी सी एक फोटो डाली थी आपके लिए, याद आया? और आज तो मैंने plants की general plants की फोटो डाली. थोड़े दिन पहले मैंने एक red algae की फोटो डाली थी. चलो characteristics of algae family. And see here at Vedanta Biotonic, I will tell you, especially जो 2022 वालों, उनके लिए बहुत important message है. बेटा कोई भी चीज़ ऐसे बहुत जल्दबाजी में भी करने की ज़रूरत नहीं. We have a lot of time. तो we are going slow, we are going steady, and we are making sure कि आपकी पढ़ाई बहुत अच्छे तरीके से हो. Point number one. और 2020 वालों, आपके लिए भी अभी सा time है. Right, you have, okay, officer. So please make sure that you go in depth, जैसा कि मैं पढ़ाने वाली हूँ. Go slow, steady, make notes, छोटे-छोटे topics करो, छोटे-छोटे topics के MCQs करो. करें? चल, let's move it. Algae are chlorophyll bearing. They have chlorophyll. So when they have mentioned chlorophyll, what do they want to say? They want to say that they have the ability to do photosynthesis. Thalloid, they have a body like this. The body does not grow like this. They have a body which spreads like this. autotrophic, they make their own food, photosynthetic, largely found in aquatic, both freshwater as well as marine. So you will have marine algae, you will have freshwater algae, you will find them in lakes, you will find them in sea, right? Moist stones, very important. You will not find them in completely dry conditions. Soil which is moist, lakdi pe lag jata hai, fungus, lichen ke saath, it forms a symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship. Right, everybody? I will explain this in detail. And animals. This is really interesting. I've never seen a sloth bear with algae, but I've seen a sloth bear with algae on National Geographic. This is a really lazy bear. Really, really lazy. It doesn't move. Can you imagine? It just doesn't move. It stays on the same position for a very long period of time. So just anywhere, aise better rahega. To iske upar ye Amazon rainforest mein hota hai, Brazil mein hota hai. Yes, everybody? Right, I'll make mind maps. So iske upar bhi algae lag jati hai. It's an animal which has algae growing on it. Aur algae jab iske upar lagti hai, to it gets camouflaged. Sloth is a word for anybody who's very, very lazy. It doesn't move at all. Let's come one by one to details of plant kingdom or algae. Now, if you look carefully, this is your parent colony. Parent colony. See how it is? Algae. And can you see small round structures which are formed inside it? These will be your daughter colonies. That is how algae develops and spreads. Right? So the daughter colonies are getting formed inside the parent. Lichen is a symbiotic relationship between fungus and algae rather. So this is very important. Can you see the daughter algae? And can you see the parent colonies? So algae is very important. It's very difficult to remember. So it's very important that you attend classes and pay attention in the class. Right? Menti bilkul hoga. Kyun nahi hoga? So ye parent colony hai. This is nothing but wall walks. Wall walks reproduces like this. Agar main aapko bolu, iski shape mujhe bataiye. Is it looking like a cup? If I tell you whatever I'm marking with red, try to tell me the shape. Is this looking like a cup? A small cup. So Chlamydomonas with two flagellas has a cup-shaped chloroplast. Very important. So some questions like this come. The ones which form a round structure with daughter cells or daughter colonies inside is wall walks. Let's get into characteristics of algae in a lot of depth. Very important. Algae can either be unicellular. Very important point. Lagta ki algae unicellular hi hoti hai? No. Algae can be unicellular or even multicellular. Algae lack a well-defined body. Inke bahar koi, they don't have a structure. They don't have a specific structure. They don't have a body. So they don't have a well-defined structure. Inke paas roots nahi hoti hai, no. They don't have stem, no. They don't have leaves. So jab anybody who lacks roots, stem and leaves, it's called as thalloid. What is it called? It's called as thalloid. Samajh mein aa raha hai mere class 11th ke bachcho? Baakiyon ko to samajh mein aa jayega. Class 11th. Right? Yes, Eulothrix is girdle shaped. Are you understanding class 11th? Perfect clear? Perfect. Reproduction occurs in both asexual as well as sexual forms. Asexual reproduction happens with the help of spores, not seeds. It does not produce seeds. So asexual reproduction happens with the help of spores. Algae are free living. They can live on their own, on water or on wet soil. Some can form a symbiotic relationship. So a symbiotic relationship between fungus and generally alga is referred to as a lichen. A symbiotic relationship is called a lichen. Sim means they are living together, both of them are helping each other. Let's come to the examples of algae. Very, very important slide. So this is a very important slide. Very important slide. Yes, click a snapshot, write down every word. Very important, multiple times it's an MCQ question. Let's move ahead. Microscopic, the one you need a microscope, you can't see them with naked eyes, is Chlamydomonas. The one which forms colonies, which I showed you. This is Chlamydomonas with cup-shaped chloroplast. The ones which form a colony is called wall walks. The one which is filamentous, like this. It is filamentous. You can see this here. See? See long filaments. It's called the Ulothrix or Spirogyra. Spirogyra is the one which grows on ponds. So it's called as pond silk. The green covering over pond is nothing but Spirogyra. Are you getting my point? Aur bachcho ek kaam to bilkul nahi karna, wo hai like karna. Aisha, thank you. So this is a very important slide. Microscopic, colonial, filamentous, flagellated, non-flagellated. Very important. It's called as pond silk. Very important. Don't miss. Right? Pond silk. Iska ek aur naam main aapko bata deti hu. It's also referred to as pond scum. Scum is anything which is dirty. Scum. Right? Flagellated and similar sized gametes. This word is very important. They have gametes which are of the same size, Chlamydomonas. Non-flagellated and similar sized gametes are Spirogyra. Spirogyra does not have gametes, does not have similar sized, it does have similar sized gametes, does not have flagella. Very important. Any doubts, guys? Understanding, Aza? Yes, and in your NCRTs, Chlamydomonas could be given in both protista as well as algae. It's unicellular, right? Unicellular with the nucleus. So that will put it in, you like Euglena, it will be put in protista. But it has chloroplast, it has the ability to do photosynthesis. So it could even come in unicellular algae. Not multicellular, but unicellular algae, because it has a cup-shaped chloroplast. It has the ability to do photosynthesis. Right, everybody? Very Spirogyra, filamentous green algae. Let's come to the classification of algae. So if it's green in color, it's called as chloro. If it's brown in color, it's called as pheo. Sargassum is very important because it gives us iodine. If it's red in color because of a pigment called phycoerythrin, it's called rhodophyce. So how many types of algae? Basically three. It could be green, if it's green, chloro. If it's brown, which gives us iodine, it is sometimes so big, kelps are so big, ke bahut badi badi ships ke rudders mein faske, they've even stopped ships for some time on the seas. So let's get going. Let's do each one of them in detail. Especially the names are very, very important here. Let's go back to the previous slide, my dear children. Right? Laminaria, Sargassum are sources of iodine. Very important. Chlorophyce is Chlamydomonas, which is unicellular, Wallbox, which is colonial, Ulothrix, Spirogyra, and Chara. Very, very important. Chara comes in exams, Chlamydomonas comes in exams, Wallbox, even Ulothrix, all of them, I put a star mark on all of them because each one of them have come in exams. They're green in color. Brown algae, basically called as Pheophyce. Ye word bahut aata hai, Pheophyce. Is brown algae. Ectocarpus, very big. Ectocarpus, dictyota, ye word bahut aata hai. Laminaria, iodine is manufactured from laminaria. Sargassum, fucus, very, very important. These are your brown algae. They basically, they are very, very big. They can even have the ability to stop ships. Then comes to rhodophyce, red algae. Polysiphonia, important. Porphyra, important. But the most important are Gracilaria and Gilladium. Very important. These are the ones which come in exam. This is the basic classification of, dependent on colors. Hai na Daleep, samajh mein aa raha hai bachcho? Great kelps. Understood? Any doubts in this? So, humne teen type ki algae kar li. Chlorophyce, Pheophyce aur Rhodophyce. Aur ye bahut zyada important hai. Theek hai? Mentium karne wale Gracilaria and Gilladium agar agar dete hain. They give us agar. Just pe hum, we grow bacterias on them. We do grow bacteria. Yes, one more thing. Aur ek cheez, just like that I'm telling you, right at the beginning of the lecture, choti si cheez main aapko batana chahti hu, bachcho, very, very important. All your MBBS studies, everything in your MBBS, your interaction with your patients, your studies, your books is going to be in English. Yes, you have any seniors who are studying, then all these things are going to be there only in English. I'm not saying Hindi is a good language, English is a bad language, English is a good language, Hindi is a bad language, nothing like that. But it is important, it is the language of the future. It's the language of the global community. It's a language with which everybody talks with everybody once you go out into the outer world. Especially when you go to a hospital, you treat patients. Write everybody all your books there. So it's a very common language. It's simple, whatever we explain. It's very simple language, isn't it? So let's slowly try and build up in that language, isn't it? Yes, everybody? Understood? Any doubts? I hope you all agree with me. राइट चल मेंटी आएगा बच्चों थोड़ा पढ़ाई कर ले फिर मेंटी करते हैं. ये बच्चे मेंटी पे बहुत ज्यादा सेंटी हैं बट पहले थोड़ी पढ़ाई होगी फिर मेंटी पे हम सेंटी होंगे चल के. चलिए आइए रिप्रोडक्शन. हाउ डज एल्गी एक्चुअली रिप्रोड्यूस. हाउ डज इट रिप्रोड्यूस. Zoo sports. What does this word mean? Zoo basically is a place where you keep animals. That means it has something to do with animals. That means it will have a flagella. It will cause some amount of movement, won't it? A spore of certain algae, fungi and protozoa capable. Zoo spores algae mein hote hain, fungus mein hote hain, protozoa mein hote hain. They are capable of swimming by means of flagella. They can swim. Isogamy. Isosceles triangle is a triangle when both the sides are similar. So when you have a triangle with both the sides similar, you call it isosceles. Isogamy. When both the sides are similar, it's isosceles triangle. So when both the gametes are similar in size, it's called as isogamy. Spirogyra. That's how spirogyras reproduce. They reproduce by fusion of the gametes. Very important from MCQ point of view. Very, very important. Both the gametes are similar. An isogamy. Dono gametes rahe wo similar nahi hain. Fusion of two gametes. Dissimilar in size. Example, Chlamydomonas. Right? Similar nahi hain. And bachcho, especially mere pyare 11th ki bachcho, if you pay attention, we've started from one side. 11th. Aise humne hotspot shuru nahi kiya ki koi bhi 11th ka topic leke aapko padha rahe hain. कुछ भी टॉपिक उठाया कोई भी किया. सी वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम चैप्टर वन तो आपका बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस डेवलप हो सकता है. येस और नो कम ऑन इलेवेंथ वाले बच्चों. टीना जी कितनी बार बोलेंगे आपको मेंटी आ रहा है ना. करेक्ट राइट. सो प्लीज पे अटेंशन स्टार्ट मेकिंग नोट्स. वी आर गोइंग इन अ वेरी सिस्टमैटिक मैनर. इट विल रियली हेल्प यू. सो टू गैमेट्स डिसिमिलर इन साइज क्लैमाइडोमोनास. Oogamy, if the egg is large and it is non-motile because it got yolk, it's got food for the zygote. Static, it's non-motile. Female gamete and is smaller because it doesn't have yolk, it doesn't have food. So it becomes much more motile male gamete. Example is Wallvox and Fucus. So remember each of the examples, every word in this slide. It's a very, very important slide. Please don't miss it. Write all these things down. Those of you who have not been attending the classes, will miss a lot. I repeat again, those of you who's not been attending classes will miss a lot. Every word of this, zoospores, spirogyra, chlamydomonas, Wallvox, Fucus, every word is important. It will come in examination as such. Copy it down. Moving ahead to the next one. Plant kingdom pe aate hain. Ab hum chlorophyceae se shuru karte hain. Green algae. Then we'll move to rhodophyceae. Right? Pheophyceae. Ek ek karke we will finish all of them. And then the mega mentee. In which I'm going to give a special gift from my side today. So unicellular hote hain. Chlorophyceae usually. It can have a single cell. कॉलोनी बना सकते हैं. दे कैन फॉर्म कॉलोनीज और इट कैन बी फिलामेंटस लाइक स्पायरोगायरा. पिगमेंट्स कौन से होंगे. पिगमेंट्स इज 100% गारंटीड क्वेश्चन. देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. दिस इज 100% गारंटीड क्वेश्चन. पिगमेंट्स राइट. क्लोरोफिल ए एंड बी. दीज आर द टू पिगमेंट्स इन क्लोरोप्लास्ट. राइट. क्लोरोप्लास्ट की शेप कैसी होती है. डिस्क प्लेट इस ये शेप होती है क्लोरोप्लास्ट की. Disc shaped like this, plate shaped, reticulate is like a mesh, jali, reticulate is this shape, like a mesh, mesh, reticulate, cup shaped, this shaped, see, it's like a cup, can you see this, I'm going to fill it up so that you're able to see it, make diagrams, I always in my regular classes ask students to make diagrams like this. And what I also want to tell you about WeBiotonic is, it's one channel, all your botany, all your zoology will be done here in a lot of detail. See, so this is a cup shaped, correct? You can see this, done, chale. It could be spiral when it is this shaped, it could be ribbon shaped, or various species have various shapes. The green algae is green in color because it has chlorophyll. If it has chlorophyll, it will do photosynthesis. Yes or no? If it will do photosynthesis, it will make food. If it will make food, it will store the starch or the food. The food in green plants is starch. So the starch storing bodies. Write this down. Pigment hai to photosynthesis karega. Photosynthesis hai to food banayega. Food is starch. So the place where it will store the food is called as pyrenoids. It will do photosynthesis and it will store the food. Understanding? Guys, and you have to do everything for V-biotonic, but you don't have to do one thing. And that one thing which you don't have to do is, you don't have to like the session. Yes. Come on, Kanjus Bachcho, that's a trademark V-biotonic. 11th standard, aap please 13th standard se ye mat sikhiye. Dreamers bahut Kanjus hai, aap mat sikhiye ye cheez. Yes. Located in the chloroplast contain proteins besides starch. 80%, 85% starch hoga, ho sakta hai, thoda bahut protein bhi ho. So I repeat, unicellular, colonial ya filamentous ho sakte hai, pigments honge, chlorophyll A and B, pigment hoga, photosynthesis karega, it will store the food in the form of pyrenoid. Cup-shaped, reticulate, discoid, plate-like spiral are the various shapes of the chlorophyll molecule. Let's move ahead. Can you see such a beautiful photograph of Chlamydomonas, such a beautiful photograph. See the cup-shaped chloroplast, see. And see both the flagella, see. Exactly like this, you can see it. Yes or no, like the shape. And all of you should hit the bell icon so that you don't miss even one single class. Right? Guys, and are you all joining Vedantu_Biotronic? Guys, those of you who are missing the class are going to miss a lot. Such an amazing, amazing class. Right? Chal. Cell wall bahut rigid hoti hai. Very tough. Very, very tough cell wall. Very inelastic. Doesn't move. Extremely inelastic cell wall. It's made up of cellulose. An outer layer of pectose. Very important, whatever I'm underlining. Right? Vegetative reproduction is with the help of fragmentation. It breaks down into pieces. Itni badi algae hai. Aap iske piece kar dijiye. कर दिया आपने पीस, देखिए पीस नंबर 1, 2, 3 दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फ्रेगमेंटेशन और नो सीड्स इट विल प्रोड्यूस स्पोर्स वन बाय वन वी विल मूव अहेड टुडे इफ आई एम डूइंग एल्गी टुमारो आई विल डू ब्रायोफाइट्स डे आफ्टर टुमारो आई विल डू टेरिडोफाइट्स आई विल नॉट फिनिश एवरीथिंग इन वन क्लास अंडरस्टूड यस एवरीबडी एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन फ्लैजेलेटेड ज़ूस्पोर स्पोर बनाएगा विद फ्लैजेला जिस स्पोर में फ्लैजेला होगा उसको ज़ूस्पोरांजिया कहेंगे सो क्लोरोफाइसी के पास ज़ूस्पोरांजिया होगा गैमीट्स विल बी सिमिलर अगर सिमिलर हुए गैमीट्स आइसोगैमी हो सकता है कुछ गैमीट्स डिसिमिलर हो एनाइसोगैमी It could also happen that some of the gametes have a big egg and a smaller male gamete. If that happens, it is oogamy. Did you understand this entire thing? Fragmentation is very important. Cellulose is very important. Tough inelastic cell wall is very important. Chlorophyce, Chlamydomonas cup-shaped stomata. Stomata to kya cup-shaped chloroplast is very important. Let's come to pheophyce. Can you see how big they are? I told you that time only. Brown algae will be very big. Sometimes it will even get stuck in the boat, right? Or in big ships. No worries, Mehek. We are missing you in the class, but don't be late. They are marine. They are found in oceans. They are found in seas. It's marine. Kelps. They are called as kelps. Pigment is chlorophyll A and C. Pigments are carotenoids and xanthophylls, which will give them brownish, yellowish color. Right? They don't really have a greenish color. It's looking like this because of refraction. They will have a brownish color. Right? Reserved food. They do have reserved food. There, the reserved food was pyrenoid, which was made up of starch as well as proteins. The reserved food is laminarin or mannitol. This question has come at least 200 times in MCQs. What is the reserved food? What is the reserved food? Laminarin or mannitol? मैनिटोल इज द रिजर्व्ड फूड. फोटोसिंथेसिस करेंगे, खाना बनाएंगे. रिजर्व फूड क्या होगा आपका? लैमिनरिन या मैनिटोल. थैंक यू अक्षय. फ्यूकोजैंथिन भी इनके पास होगा. दे हैव प्लास्टिड्स, दे हैव अ वैक्यूल इन द सेंटर एंड दे हैव अ न्यूक्लियस. सेलुलोसिक वॉल है बाहर, बिकॉज दे आर मरीन दे रिक्वायर सम प्रोटेक्शन. एक जेली की कवरिंग होती है या एल्जिन की कवरिंग होती है टुवर्ड्स द आउटसाइड बिकॉज दे आर फाउंड इन सीज, सो दे आर वेरी वेरी स्लिपरी. ओशन और सी में पाए जाते हैं, ब्राउनिश कलर के होते हैं. फ्यूकोजैंथिन पिगमेंट हो सकता है. स्टोर्ड फूड इज लैमिनेटेड और मैनिटोल. सेंट्रल वैक्यूल होता है. जेलेटिनस कवरिंग इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द आउटसाइड. प्लांट किंगडम में फियोफाइसी और रहते हैं. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ये ब्राउन एल्गी का मैं एक डायग्राम बनाकर आपको दिखा रही हूं. They don't have root-like structures. First, we will do the diagram. It's a very important diagram. Multiple times MCQ. Then we are going to move ahead into the rest of the parts. So, they have something which is called the holdfast. Right? The holdfast is going to do the functions of root. Root ki tarah kaam karega. They have something which is called the stipe, which is nothing but the stem. Stipe. They do also have something which is called as bladder, which is full of air, which will help them to stay afloat in the water. And then they have blades, which are nothing but the leaves. So they do not have leaf stem. Instead, they look like this. Right, everybody? Stipes, blades, fronds are the leaves. Stipe, blade, frond, ye leaf ki tarah hote hain. Plant body substratum, matlab soil pe laga hua hai, with the help of holdfast, which do the function of roots. It has a stalk called stipe and leaf ki tarah ye jo blade hai leaves ke, ek structure hota hai which is called the frond. Vegetative reproduction happens again, jaise maine aapko bola, by tukde tukde hona, which is called as fragmentation. They also form zoospores, jinke paas do flagella hote hain. The gametes can be similar, dissimilar, or the egg larger. Ye to abhi tak aapko yaad ho gaya hoga. Yes, done. Thank you, Mehak. राइट, सो ये बहुत सिंपल है, बहुत ज्यादा सिंपल. होल्ड फास्ट, ऐसे सबस्ट्रेटम को किसी सॉइल को ऐसे पकड़ लेगा. होल्ड फास्ट, स्टाइप, स्टॉक, ब्लैडर, पानी रखेगा, पानी के बीच में फ्लोटिंग में एयर ब्लैडर विल हेल्प इट टू फ्लोट. दिस इज द रोडोफाइसी और द रेड एल्गी. अगेन इट इज अ मरीन फॉर्म. पिगमेंट्स आर क्लोरोफिल ए, डी एंड फाइको एरिथ्रिन, विच इज इंपॉर्टेंट. फाइकोलॉजी ऑफ फाइको इज द स्टडी ऑफ प्लांट्स. Erythrin is a red dye. That's why erythrocytes are your RBCs. This is your red dye. This is your red colored pigment which is present. Phycoerythrin. Phycoerythrin. Right? Reserve food. Pehle se hum pad rahe hain. Sabse pehle reserve food mein humne kya padha? We read about something. Achha, sabse pehle reserve food mein kya padha? Batao. Anjali. Is it Anjali? Thank you. Gracilaria also is the same thing here which we are studying. सबसे पहले हमने रिजर्व फूड में क्या पढ़ा? नीलग्रीव जोशी, पाइरिनोइड्स. सेकंड हमने क्या पढ़ा? मैनिटोल, फ्लोरिडियन स्टार्च. थर्ड रिजर्व फूड हम क्या पढ़ने वाले हैं? फ्लोरिडियन स्टार्च. दे हैव मोर ऑफ फ्लोराइड. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. रिजर्व फूड पे एटलीस्ट 20 टाइम्स क्वेश्चन हैव कम. दे आर हैविंग नथिंग बट पिगमेंट्स. पिगमेंट्स है तो फोटोसिंथेसिस करेंगे. फोटोसिंथेसिस करेंगे तो ऑब्वियसली दे विल डू स्टार्च फॉर्मेशन. इफ दे डू स्टार्च, दे विल सेव सम ऑफ इट एंड कीप इट फॉर देमसेल्व्स, व्हिच इज नथिंग बट द रिजर्व फूड. रिप्रोडक्शन, वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन हैपेंस बाय फ्रेगमेंटेशन और ब्रेकिंग. एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, नॉन, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. टू टाइम्स वी रेड द मोटाइल स्पोर्स. दीज स्पोर्स आर योर नॉन मोटाइल स्पोर्स एंड रिप्रोडक्शन इज oogamous in terms of sexual reproduction. So the egg is bigger in size, the female gamete is bigger, the female gamete is non-motile. And who is motile? The smaller, without nutritious material, male gamete. And this is what is your rhodophyce. I've seen a rhodophyce, I've touched a rhodophyce. It's very, very slippery. And I don't know how this happened. So let's go back, right? See with the touch what happened. This, yeah, so we were here and let's do a chart. So in the next 5 minutes, we are going to begin with our super sevi, upper sevi, amazing mentee. Everybody just be prepared, right? ये आपका एनसीईआरटी का चार्ट मैंने आप लोगों के लिए रखा है, विच इज वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट. सो लेट्स कम टू क्लोरोफाइल. सी एक एक करके वी विल गो इनटू मच मोर डेप्थ ऑफ ऑल दीज थिंग्स बाय द एंड ऑफ द ईयर. आई कैन ओनली प्रॉमिस यू डोंट मिस एनी क्लास. That's the only promise that I want from you. एक भी क्लास मिस नहीं करनी. मिस हो गई उसी टाइम जा वापस घर आके रिकॉर्डिंग देखनी. By the end of the year, I will make you total James Bond, absolute James Bond of biology. Done. You'll be like every question, everything you'll be able to do. Done, guys. Yes. चलिए आइए. बिल्कुल राधे जी. Chlorophyce is green. Pheo is brown. Rhodo is AB, fucoxanthin, which comes in exams, and erythrin. I'm underlining the things which come in the exam. We've done everything. Starch, pyrenoids, mannitol and laminarin, floridian starch. Isi se question aayenge. Nothing comes from outside NCRT. There are a lot of people, a lot of teachers who've done PhDs, a lot of teachers who, and unko lagta hai yaar jitni knowledge hai na algae mein de do. उनको ये नहीं पता 38 चैप्टर्स हैं, हर किसी से क्वेश्चन आएंगे. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? एलगी से एक या दो क्वेश्चन आने, उतना ही पढ़ाना है. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट एवरीबॉडी? और जब आपने भी पढ़ना है बच्चों, यही सोच के पढ़ना है दैट यू डोंट हैव टू डू पीएचडी, यू हैव टू डू दिस मच दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर नीट. यस एवरीबॉडी. ओ द इंसेट ड्रू दिस. ओ या आई थिंक इंसेट्स आल्सो कम इन टू स्टडी बायोलॉजी. By the way, I can catch snakes. I know how to catch snakes. I'm not afraid of snakes and insects. Yeah, the insects, I think the kids are also interested in studying biology. Try and trap him after the class. Why not? Don't want to kill him, just trap him and probably leave him outside the class. Yeah? Okay. So we come to cellulose. Yeah? Chali, padhe, aage padhe. Yes. So we come to cellulose, which is a cell wall. Cellulose, algin. Algin, very important. Cellulose. So cellulose, not so important. Algin, yes, indeed. It's not really very difficult. It's just flying away. I'll catch the insect after the class, right? Chaliye. So we have flagella. I think it's really interesting. Want some fame? Says, come to me, buy a tonic, get some fame. Right, Ajay. 228 equal. There's so many lights in the studio, no? So the insects generally. I remember. How many of you remember when there was a lizard in the class? You remember? Oh, Megasporophyll is not a part of this class. Thank you, Vineet. There's an insect in the class. That's okay. Never mind. Happens. 228 equal apical flagella. Not so important. Not so important. I'm not marked it. Not important. Brackish water is salty water, salt and sweet, like backwaters, where the fresh water meets the salty water. Right, everybody? Fresh water, salty water, salt water most. This is important because this is usually found in seas. The red one is generally found in sea. Done? Any doubts? Okay, chale. So I think this is entirely done. Excited for Menti now? Should we move ahead to the Menti quiz? I hope aapne self ki class bhi dekh liyo 2021 walo. It's very important. And aaj aapko pata hai Menti mein special gift milne wala hai. And ye sare aapki playlist hai. Have you all seen the playlist? Have you all seen the playlist? Have you? Pakka promise? Chalo. So without any further delay, let's move on to our Menti. Plant kingdom, algae, menti, starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, full screen. And your code for the day is 537739. 537739. You can see the code exactly. That's your code. Go to menti.com, use the code 537739. That's your code for the day. 537739. On your screens, quick. Come on. All of you, special prize today for those of you who win the Menti. All the questions are from the class. तो ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है जो क्लास के बाहर से है. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है जिसमें किसी एक बैच को ज्यादा प्रॉफिट मिलने वाला है। सारे क्वेश्चंस हमारी क्लास से ही हैं। चलिए आंसर कीजिए। Wow, good number. Quick, my dear V by Johnians. Everybody has understood the class. Santa Claus, diamond ring. Oh, Vineet's got a heart and he gives it to me. Thank you, Vineet. Yeah, there are a lot of birds around now. Hanji, Duruk, bilkul aaj 9 baje class hogi. Is it Mayuri? Chali. So, aaj hamari 9 baje class hogi. Hi Shaurya, bio was never so interesting. Priyanshi, pyrenoid stored more starch. Hanji Malika, thank you Radhe Solanki. Travel, aap ek bar mere se touch mein aa jaiye on Telegram, I will do that. Chali, starting in 5, starting in 4, everybody, we had 800 people watching. Is it Swadin? Nice, chali. Starting in 5. Haha, thank you, Srishti. Hanji. So let's start in 5, 4, 3, 2. Quick. We start in as soon as we touch 700, we start. Everybody, come on, quick. We're giving you all that you have to do is go to menti.com and use the code 537739. That's about it. So I'm going to start the quiz now. On your screens, please start. You can do that. I'm the admin of Vedanta Biotonic in case anybody wants to get in touch with me on Telegram. The classification of algae is based on types of pigment, nature of the cell wall, nature of the reserve food, whether it's cyanophycin starch, what is it, the pigments, A, B, C, phycoerythrin, what is the nature of the cell wall, what is it, all the above. Think before you ink. You must read all the options and you must think before you ink. You have 5 more seconds and it's a 3, it's a 2, 1, and your time's up. And the answer has to be all the above. But some of you did not read the options. Haste makes waste. You know that, right? So types of pigment is the answer, but the real answer is all the above. Yes, everybody, don't hurry. Haste always makes waste. It's the type of the pigment, ABC, chlorophyll, phycoerythrin, right? Fucoxanthin, nature of the cell wall, whether it's made up of cellulose, whether it's made up of pectose, whether it has alginate, it is the nature of reserve food, whether it is pyrenoid, whether it has cyanophycin starch, whether it has chloridian starch, right? Moving ahead to the next question on the screens, please. Good, well done, I'm proud of you. Algae, which, oh, I did it, it's a colony and it's motile. Wallbox, Nostoc, Spirogyra, Chlamydomonas. Come on, Wallbox, Nostoc, Spirogyra, Chlamydomonas. I will, Cherry, immediately after the class. 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, you still have 8 seconds. Never mind, do it well. 9. Your time is going to be up and it's up. Colony. You got confused. Chlamydomonas is singular. It has flagella. It is motile. Motile colony. Did I show you a diagram of the colony? A round colony with daughter colonies. Colony. It is motile. Spirogyra is it doesn't have a flagella. It's just swimming on the surface of the water. Guys, don't make blunders. Don't make mistakes, please. Come on, 2022. Next question on the screens, please. Which of the following statements concerning the algae is wrong? Most algae are photosynthetic. Algae can be classified according to their pigments. All algae are filamentous. Spirogyra does not produce zoospores. Are all algae filamentous? Those of you who just joined us, 537739. And guys, are you liking sharing, subscribing to our channel for more such classes. Are you liking, sharing, subscribing? Very well done. Not all algae are filamentous, some are round. Not all spirovirus filamentous, all algae are not filamentous. Cannot be doing this mistake. Come on, next question. Not wrong, they had asked. Wrong. Not all algae are filamentous. Five, four, three, two. Okay, no, you take your time. Pyrenoids. Starch. Protein is around the periphery. I told it loud and clear. AIIMS 2012 question. I told it loud and clear. The starch will be in the center. The protein will be around it. Next question. Next question. Phycology. Phycobiota. I told you. While doing lichens also, I told you, mycology, phycology, bacteriology, microbiology. So three words, I've told you three words for it. Phycology, mycology, microbiology. Phycology, mycology, microbiology. You're new to the class, Dharani, I hope. New students, raise your hands. There's a special message for the new students. Phycology is the study of algae, not all the above. Microbiology is the study of bacteria. Mycology is the study of funguses. And phycology is the study of algae. And before we move ahead, this is our leaderboard, but one small request to you, my dear children. Because of COVID-19, hundreds of people and thousands of people have lost their jobs. So make sure, Afsar, you're on the leaderboard. I'm so happy to have you. Saksham, Diti, Yash, Pratham, Sambit, Anuja, Indu, Anchal. And it's a tie between Devanshi and... Oh my God! Oh my God, it's never happened. I think we really need to click a photograph. It has never happened. This is amazing. I really need to click a selfie. Yay! I'm going to do that. I'm going to put that everywhere. It's never happened. All the kids on 5,000. It has never happened. Like, never. Oh my God, I have to send so many gifts. Have you ever seen anything like this in any other channel? I think it is epic. Is it showing third, second place to everybody? Oh, then I think Menti's got Senti. Menti feels Vani ma'am should not give a gift to anybody and Vani ma'am should give a gift to everyone. We'll do that. I'll leave a special note for each one of you on Telegram. I'll do that, isn't it? But a special request from my side, my dear children, before you call it a day, a special request from my side of all of those who are in your touch, anybody who comes especially from an economically impoverished background, and this is a very sincere plea from a sincere teacher. It's not a plea from Vedantu also. It's not even a plea from Vedantu Biotronic. It's just a very sincere plea from a person who's a very sincere teacher at Vedantu. Anybody who requires assistance during this COVID-19 crisis, whose parents cannot afford to send their kids to schools or colleges at this time, but the kid wants to study, do tell them about our channel. It'll be a big work that you do for India, for people who want to study. You promise me you will do that? Yes. And I'm going to see you sharp at 9 o'clock now. Bye, kids. Bye. Take care. Right? Take care. Everybody's on this space. So I'll send you a special message on Telegram. Take care. Bye-bye. Sharp at 9.